Hello everyone, it's Troy here from Tennis Warehouse, back again with another vlog this week. For the vlog, I have pretty much everything 18 by 20 string patterned rackets for you guys. In the last few months, we've had some really, really nice rackets, great performance. We've reviewed a lot of these rackets and given them some really high praises. So the 18-20 patterns are back better than ever. If you like that type of control and feel, we got a lot of great options for you with some recent releases, as well as a couple of our other favorites that aren't necessarily brand new, but great performance like a lot of these other ones. So to start things off, I have the head Graphene 360 Plus Gravity Pro, endorsed on tour by Sasha Zverev, as well as T-Dub playtester Mark Boone. And this racket, we just loved it when we reviewed it. It's really forgiving in the sense that you have a nice round 100 square inch head size, big sweet spot, but it still retains a lot of that classic control feel and touch from the really nice thin beam, low flex. It's got a nice amount of mass to it, definitely more in that player's frame spec, and it has a lot of plow through. So just a great blend of forgiveness, touch and feel, and just a great option for the 18-20 pattern lover out there with the Gravity Pro. Next one up, we have the Babolat Pure Strike 18 by 20 third generation, endorsed on tour by Dominic Thiem. Now this one here is a little bit more of a modern feeling 18 by 20, a slightly thicker beam, a little bit more firm layup, not as stiff as your Pure Drive or your Pure Arrow, definitely more touch and feel than those, but definitely a more modern 18 by 20, packs good power for an 18-20, and just a really good all around racket, not too heavy, not too light. Just really loving this one. Our playtesters all really like this one, maybe our favorite Pure Strike of the bunch. So that's the Strike 18-20 third gen. Next up, a racket with very similar specs from Technifiber. This is the TF40-305, endorsed by the T-Dub playtest team, by the legendary vlogman Chris Edwards, as well as our Frenchie Julie Goggery. Just loving this racket. Just has really good balance of like touch feel. You get a lot of control from that 18-20 pattern, still spin friendly for an 18-20 like the others, and just really nice specs here. For me, it's a little bit more controlled than the Strike, a little softer, but maybe not as much control as the next one I'm gonna talk about. So that's a beautiful looking racket there, TF40 from Technifiber. Next one up, we have the Blade 98 18-20 version 7. And this one here is competing maybe for my favorite of all the 18-20 rackets, just because I have some history with the Blade, but a really nice update from Wilson. They don't have the countervail in it like the previous version, so just maybe a little bit more touch and feel. And we're just really loving the overall performance of this racket. Packs some good power from the swing weight. It's got a higher swing weight, easy plow through, but still that low flex, and just I can really command the ball around the court. This one here has some tail weight on it, shrink sleeve, leather grip on top, coming out about 12.3 ounces strung. So I'm really liking the headlight feel, the way I doctored it up. Nice frame there from Wilson. Then going into the addition to the V-Core Pro line from Yonex, Yonex brought out this HD version with the update of the V-Core Pros. I've been using the V-Core Pro 330 for the past year and a half or so now, and this addition to the line is very much appreciated. Just a ton of touch and feel, lots of command of the ball. It's got a low flex, about a 59, but it doesn't play too flexy or noodly, as we say. It still has some good backbone, some good pop to it. And the specs of this racket are just really nice. It's got good mass, but still maneuvers pretty well. And this is just a beautiful racket. Great addition to the V-Core Pro line. Much appreciated from Yonex. That's a 97 HD. And then we have a re-release of somewhat of a classic here. And every time I pick this racket up, it just takes me down memory lane. I used to use the 6195 1820 for quite some time with the BLX versions. And this is a re-release of the K-Factor. Just a really nice looking racket. When you pick it up, I can just close my eyes and know I'm picking up a K, not a K-Factor, but a 6-1. It's just got that spec, that like 12.2, 12.3 high swing weight. And this one here, compared to the other 6-1s that have come out in the past, it's got a little bit stiffer layup in it, a little bit higher stiffness rating, packs some good punch, some plow, just a nice racket. Get them while they last. K-Factor 6195 1820. So those are the newer releases. A couple of other ones that aren't quite as new, but still great frames. Another one from Head, the Graphene 360 Speed Pro, endorsed by Novak Djokovic. Like the Gravity Pro, has the 18-20 string pattern, But this one swings a little faster. It's a little bit more modern feel, slightly firmer, slightly crisper. You're getting a little bit more pop, kind of a more powerful 1820, kind of like the Strike. So just a really nice one there for forgiveness with the head size and then maneuverability, hence the name Speed. Another couple from Prince. We have the Techstream Tour 100P. 100 square inch, more of Prince's modern 18x20. Another one that's pretty forgiving with the head size, easy power, not too hefty. So just a really user-friendly 18x20. And then if you wanna go throwback, traditional, mid-size, classic control and feel, this one, in most people's opinion, is gonna have the most control, the most feel out of all these 18x20s. It's just a beautiful frame, just amazing feel on contact. Low, low powered, but man, the ability to command the ball precision is just amazing with this one. That's the Phantom Pro 93P. And then last but not least, one of my favorites, as well as like the blade, the Dunlop Strixon CX200 Tour, endorsed on tour by Kevin Anderson, is just another lovely touch and feel frame, great comfort, nice thin beam. And this one comes in a little bit lower weight than say like the Phantom 93P and easy to customize. I have some weight at the 3 and 9, leather grip, a little bit of tungsten in the handle. So a nice one to doctor up, mess with the specs, but another great offering there from Dunlop Strixon. And that's all I have for the 1820 rackets today. That wraps up this week's vlog. Be sure to tune in next week.